roles of gender in disasters, because these are the kinds of images that we see all the time. Next. So a lot of times women are used as the face of disaster, but and it's practical, because these women are sympathetic, and for strategic purposes, for relief assistance, women, children, these faces of disaster are helpful in getting funding and getting relief assistance. But while we're depicting women as victims of disaster, a lot of times these depictions do not talk about with women as victims of the domestic violence or acts of violence that occur during crisis. And at this meeting, we've been talking a little bit about some of those acts of violence. But before the tsunami, a lot of disasters, we did not hear about any of the acts of violence that were going on. During this disaster in particular, we started hearing of women being pulled out of waters and into dark corners. Or there were actually some recorded incidences of women that were victims of rape following during the disaster crisis and also following. It is important that we also see, when we see these images of disaster, that women are victims of, that we acknowledge that women are also being victimized by violence as well, and that men are not only heroes, rebuilders, but also victims of disaster. This slide that we have up right now is showing we saw earlier, and it shows by income level and by disaster type the number of incidences and the type of disasters that occur. You can see on the top lower income level down to higher income level, and you see the different kinds of disaster, and it's hard to read some of them, but if you look at the top, the yellow one stands out very clearly, and this is a drought. The dark green is a windstorm or hurricane, tropical cyclone. We see the pink colors, purple colors, but you don't see as much of those colors in array and those types of disasters the higher income, at higher income levels. There's less exposure to those disasters. What we see in this slide is that at lower income levels, there's a lot more exposure to hydrometeorological hazards. So those hazards that are related to climate, such as drought and windstorms and hurricanes and even wave surge action. So you can see the vast differences. And one of the reasons why, when we're talking about disasters here, we're also emphasizing the climate adaptation portion, because climate disasters are some of the most extensive, and the areas where the poorer people are, the more exposed they are to climate hazards. Next. This slide shows the types of the trends in the types of disasters, and again, it shows that there's been an increase in the types of hydrometeorological disasters. Next. And in this kind of disaster, you see that the victims are in large part women. Now, we didn't, in this database that's recorded all of the disasters, the last two slides, it shows income level, but you didn't see sex disaggregated data, because that database does not hold the sex disaggregated data that shows us specifically the links of the gender and the disaster in these areas. There's been a study that was emphasized yesterday that was completed in 2007, and the quote by the researcher who did that study was, "The feminists got it right. Natural disasters are a tragedy in their own right, but in countries with existing gender discrimination, women are the worst hit." And in the study, correlating the disasters that have occurred with a number of the social social variables, socioeconomic variables that women and men deal with in their lives, this study showed that the life expectancy for women decreases as a result of the incidence of disasters. So in general, women have a longer life expectancy than men do, but the exposure to disasters tends to decrease that life expectancy. Next slide. We've had some really good conversations where today and yesterday, where we're talking about what the root issues of vulnerability are. And I just wanted to go through this slide really quickly, because a lot of times when people are talking about vulnerability, there is a tendency just to label different groups of people as vulnerable. And in doing so, we start ignoring what the capacities, what the actual root causes, what the exposures are, and then what people can do to actually reduce their risks. So if we say that women are vulnerable, we're blocking out women. We can say children are the most vulnerable. We leave out all the children. Those that are disabled, those that are due to illness. And if we start blocking out all those different groups related to the labels that we apply of vulnerability, we end up with a very tiny, small corner of the population of males between the ages of 19 and 44 that maybe aren't labeled as vulnerable. And if you then were to have a conflict in the area, and if you think about the 2004 tsunami, two of the places, Sri Lanka and Aceh, were in the midst of conflict. And so that added on to what was going on in the disaster occurrence. So then we start looking at everybody as being vulnerable. And so we have to start teasing out what the exposures are to different factors. Disasters have different types, and that will create different exposures to different sensitivities by location, by the places that people live, by class, by ethnic background. So in understanding vulnerability, you have to do a lot of examination in the questions and the root causes of why the vulnerability exists. Next slide. So a lot of times when we're talking, this audience more so understands than other groups, but there is a connection with gender and disaster risk reduction. But a lot of times groups that deal with disaster management tend to not see those connections as readily. So one of the first things to clear is, what does gender mean? A lot of times the word gender is substituted for women, and people think that when we're talking about gender and disaster risk reduction, we're only referring to the special needs of women. But we've highlighted the reasons why that we focus a lot on women is because women tend to be, in a lot of different disasters, the largest group of victims. And that's been brought out a lot in this conference. And also because we're focusing on women in this conference, it is an important area to focus on. But also when we're talking about gender and disaster risk reduction policies, we need to make it clear that we're not just talking about women's issues. We're talking about women, men, boys, girls. Gender, when you do analysis with gender, it isn't just one isolated component that you're looking at. It attaches to other things like age, like your ethnic background, your cultural background, the class that you exist in, your income levels, and all of these different factors combine when you're starting to look at gender as a unit of analysis.